quantum mechanics gave us a way to accurately calculate the probability of where an electron was in an atom using wave. Turns out that Heisenberg's uncertainty principle allowed us to either calculate the specific location of an electron or to know the energy of the wave, but we couldn't do both at the same time. Quantum mechanics uses the wave notion to accurately predict the behavior of elements. The loss of this is that we only got a probability of where an electron was. We can give an address to this probability by using quantum numbers. Best way to think about quantum numbers is it's kind of like an address for us. You would be in a country, state, town, street, and then your street address. And that would give us a probability of where we might be able to find you. You may or may not be there, but it would give us a probability. So when we think about electron densities and quantum numbers, that's what we're getting with quantum mechanics. There are four quantum numbers: the principal quantum number, the angular momentum quantum number, the magnetic quantum number, and the electron spin quantum number. These are given by N, L, mth of L, and mth of S. N is our basic energy levels. If we think about it, we can think about it as size. And they correlate very well to the Bohr model. They're integers, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so forth. L is defined by N minus 1. If N is 0, then L can only be 0. If N is 1, then L has to be 0. If N is 2, then L can be 1 and 0. Our next quantum number is mth of L. As you might determine from the fact that it's mth of L, it's going to be defined by L. Mth of L is our orientation. It's usually given by minus L, as whole integers down to 0, and then past 0 up to plus L. If we take L equals 1, that means that our orientations for mth of L will be minus 1, 0, and plus 1. Our last quantum number, mth of S, is the electron spin quantum number. It really only has two possible values, minus 1 half and plus 1 half. When we look at all of this together, it gives us the probable location of electron based on the electron density map that we calculated by quantum mechanics. Let's take an example. Let's take N equals 2. So we're going to look at an element that has an energy level at least 2. From that will give us two possible L, or shapes. Those shapes will be 0 and 1. If we think about the mths of L, for example, where L is 0 and 1, the mths of L for L equals 0 is 0. There's only going to be one orientation. If we look at the mths of L where L equals 1, we're going to have three orientations, minus 1, 0, and 1. If we think about this in three dimensions, these can be along our axis, x, y, and z. Now, for each of these orientations, we're going to have two possible mths of S. We will have the minus 1 half and the plus 1 half. If we put these all together, this will give us a probable location for our electron. We're going to combine these to give the electron configurations. One more piece of information. When we looked at our L, 0, 1, 2, and 3, they had specific shapes. The shape for 0 was S. The 0 actually gives us some very important information about the shape. There are no nodes in this three-dimensional shape. For L equals 1, that's referred to as P, or the P shape. Since L equals 1, it has one node, so all the shapes in P will have one node. When we look at L equals 2, we refer to that as D. It's going to have two nodes. And when we look at L equals 3, that is F, and it'll have three nodes. All of the quantum numbers give us probable electron densities and locations for our electrons. We're going to be able to use these along with electron configurations and the periodic table to help us predict the reactivity and the physical properties of the elements.